Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to fade an image to transparent background in Adobe Photoshop. All right, let's get started. Okay, here's the image that I want to fade, and this is from pexels.com. I'll just click and drag this onto my Photoshop icon, and it'll open in here. I'm going to Command minus or Control minus to zoom out a little bit. And I want to make sure I have my layers panel up. If you don't see this, it's going to be under Window and it's right here. The first thing I want to do is add a mask to this layer, whatever layer you want to fade. So I'll come down here and choose this mask button right here. And it'll add this little box. Now I'll click on that box. Next, hit D on your keyboard to get a white fill and a black background. And then come up here to the gradient tool. Now this should have white on the left and black on the right. If not, hit Shift X. That'll change these colors here and it'll also change your gradient here. I'll hit Shift X again to toggle back to the white on the left. And actually this doesn't really matter. You can also make a gradient on your mask the same way. If you have it switched, you would just have to do the opposite. Now click where you want the fade to start. So I'm going to click right about the middle of the picture and I'll click and drag and I'm going to hold shift to have a straight line. Now you'll get a preview of what's going to happen if you're on a newer version of Photoshop, but if you're on an old version, you won't get to see this preview. This looks about good. So I'm going to release. And then I also have these little sliders to kind of change the strength of that gradient. I'm going to leave this right about here. If you have an older version, you won't have this option, but your layer should look like this. If you want to remove that fade, all you have to do is just drag your mask to the trash and say you just want to delete it. And that'll reveal your whole photo again. I'll undo to get the mask back. Now let's add a solid color behind it. I'll come down here to New Fill Layer, and I'm going to choose solid color right here. And we can click any color here. I think I'm going to make this kind of a red. And we'll say, okay. Then come over here and drag that fill color underneath. And now you can see it fade into that red color. You could also put an image under here. So I'll show you what that looks like. I'll go to File, Place Embedded. And then I'm going to put this water picture behind there. And we'll place that. I'm going to resize it a little bit, holding Shift and Option or Alt on a PC, and then hit Enter or Return to commit the changes. So now we sort of have this city image fading into the water, which honestly is pretty weird. It could be a good starting point, but right now it does not look good. And then we can hide that one to reveal the red color underneath. So let's save this. I'll go to File, Save As. I'm going to call this City Scene. And I'll save it just as a Photoshop document. That way your layers will stay in here. And I'll hit save. We'll say okay. Then I'm going to hide these two layers and I'll save this just as a PNG file. So File, Export, Export As, and PNG. We definitely want transparency. And then we'll choose Export. I'll also save this one as City Scene and choose save. So now I can put this photo over anything and you'll be able to see through the bottom of it. Although right now you can't in this preview. And then of course, if you also wanted the other ones, you could just turn on those layers and save that as a JPEG or PNG file. You wouldn't need transparency in this case because, you know, there is no transparency here anymore because the red is filling it in. But you definitely want to keep your Photoshop file because it'll have these layers in it. So don't throw that one away. And that's it. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.